trick-or-treat!
Light as a feather, stiff as a board. Light as a feather, stiff as a board. Light as a feather, stiff as a board. Light as a feather, stiff as a board.
In 1955, my grandparents moved to Lincoln. They drove around looking for a home and saw a dusty, forgotten, for sale sign in front of a large, spooky house. This house. They fell in love with the place and started their family here. However, after moving in, strange things began to happen. Jewelry went missing in the middle of the night. The radio would turn off and on at odd hours. And one night, my grandma swore she saw a little girl run down the hallway. My grandma was scared, so she went down to the library to learn more about her house and discovered in 1925, two young girls went missing from this house in the middle of the night, never to be heard from again. The librarian saw my grandma reading and came over. You bought the Jessup house, didn't you? My grandma nodded. They say it's haunted. Both those girls went missing between the hours of 1 a.m. and 2 a.m. on different nights. Their parents swore the girls were still there, haunting the hall. The poor dears went crazy. The children in town still say, "Don't be awake from 1 to 2 or the Jessup girls will come for you." So tonight, if you look around, and you're the only one awake, and the clock strikes 1.
The girls will get you!
All right, Mom says time for bed. You know you don't want to be up too late. Just kidding. Night, guys.
It's almost 1 a.m.
Your point is?
I can't sleep.
That seems more like a you problem, Zoe.
No, it's an us problem. I can't be the only one awake.
It was a story.
I know. Just stay up with me, Dev.
You're really scared.
Yes.
Fine. But you owe me.
Do you have a nine?
Zoe, this is boring. Let's meet the Jessup girls.
No. Did you see that?
No.
Almost 1:45.
Okay, bring it, clock. Try to scare me. Ha! saw something.
Zoe, this is so stupid. Can we please go to bed?
Only 15 more minutes.
I'm going to sleep.
If you go to sleep, I will get a dish of warm water.
You wouldn't.
Wouldn't I?